The major classifications of the container ships are based on their capacity to carry container. However, some vessels are categorized by their design, that is gear. Vessel has its own container handling gear like cranes, derrick, etc. Hatch coverless vessel, where the hold do not have the hatch covers for all the cargo holds, cellular container vessels, etc. Dimensions of the ship, such as the breadth of the ship, depend on the number of containers placed side by side on deck and in the holds. The average weight of the loaded containers is about 10 to 12 tons. The average weight may differ. Hence, the dimensions of the modern container vessels are designed with 12 to 14 deadweights per TEU. The capacity of the container ship is usually expressed in 20 foot equivalent units or TEU, which is defined as the number of containers it can carry with size 20 by 8 by 8.6 feet. Size of the container ships varies considerably. The capacity of some ships that serve major ports exceeds 10,000 TEUs. Some ships built for feeder service have capacities of 400 TEU or less. Feeder ships. These are small ships serving small outputs from a major port or operating in coastal waters and short sea routes. These come in sizes of 450 TEUs to 900 TEUs. Most of these feeder ships are geared ships. That is, they have their own cranes for loading and unloading, and these are used for inland waters, up rivers, canals, etc. A canal, which has the limitations on length and breadth of the container ship. The length and breadth of the lock chamber of the Panama Canal limits the passage due to the large hull dimensions of the Panamax size vessels, which are the largest container ships. That is, a maximum ship breadth of 32.3 meters, a maximum overall ship length of 294.1 meters, and a maximum draft of 12 meters. The length and width of the Panama Canal lock chambers are 305 meters and 33.5 meters respectively, while the largest depth of the canal is 12.5 to 13.7 meters. The canal is about 86 kilometers long and passage take 8 hours. Post Panamax, a new transportation net was developed by APL without the use of Panama Canal. This paved way for the creation of new post Panamax type. In 1996, the prescribed limit was exceeded with an official capacity of 6,400 TEU by Regina Maersk, and a new development was started in the container ship market. From 1996 onwards, there had been rapid increase in the maximum size of container ships from 6,600 TEU in 1997 to 7,200 TEU in 1998, and up to the maximum of 8,700 TEU in ships delivered in 1999. The capacity of delivered vessels or vessels on order that are approximately 9,000 TEU have exceeded approximately 10 meters than the Panamax. The post-Panamax fleet's development has been dramatic. Today, 30% of the world's fleet is post-Panamax. Have several passing bays with only one traffic lane. The depth of the canal is intentionally increased before 2010 in order to facilitate the building of large container ships in future. Ultra-large container ships, ULCS, that are capable of carrying 12,000 TEU containers are being delivered presently. The breadth of the ultra-large container ships is 50 meters or 57 meters and it corresponds to the maximum draft of 16.4 meters or 14.4 meters. The size of the ship may meet the present Suez max size. In about 10 years, the ULCS may be as large as 18,000 TEU with a breadth of 60 meters and draft of maximum 21 meters, which are indicated by the post-Suez max investigations. Today, the size of this ship is being categorized as a post-Suez max ship because the ship's cross-section is too big for the present Suez Canal. It is claimed that the transportation cost per containers for such a big ship may be of about 30% lower than that of a typical 5,000 to 6,000 TEU container vessel of today.